Hello everyone, my name is Megha Nandi and I'm faculty of Dr. Ambedkar Institute of Management Studies and Research, and today we are going to talk about classification of computer. So let's see the learning objectives of this topic. After this topic, you will be able to understand the classification of computer as well as to know the various types of computers. Classification of computer is based on three things. First, logic, which is also known as data handling. Second, purpose, and third, size. Now one by one we will see these three things. According to logic, computers are again classified in three parts: analog computer, digital computer, and hybrid computer. Analog computer is not a common computer. This computer generally used to measure the data, for example thermometer, speedometer, and electric meter. This computer generally used in scientific field, and it shows the result in the form of images or graphs. Like we can measure the data of temperature, speed, and current using this analog computer. Digital computer. According to its name implies, digital means digits, that is numbers. So generally this computer works with numbers, that is 0 and 1, and it also shows the result in the form of numbers. This computer generally used to count the data. Hybrid computer. Hybrid means combination of two or more things. So this computer is a combination of analog computer and digital computer. So we can say that it works with both the kinds of data, that is analog and digital. Then second classification is based on the purpose. So purpose again is classified in two categories, that is general purpose computer and special purpose computer. General purpose computers mean those computers which has no special or particular purpose. We can use this computer for anything. For example, if I want to create a document, I can create a document. If I want to calculate the result, I can calculate the result. As well as if I want to create a database, that also we can do using this computer. So this computer has no special purpose. Then special purpose computer. According to its name, this computer is used to perform some special tasks. Like it is made only for perform special things. Like if I want to calculate the result, so this computer is able to calculate the result only. So we'll say that is a special purpose computer. Then next category, which is based on the size. Again, size we are classified in two parts, that is large and small. So first we will see the large category of this computer. In this large category of computers, totally we have four computers, so one by one we will see. First, that is supercomputer. This computer is the biggest, most powerful, and the fastest computer. This computer requires a lot of space for the installation. As we can see in the picture, this computer requires a single room for the setup, and this computer generally used in scientific purpose like weather forecasting, nuclear power stations, military simulation, research laboratories, and etc. Mainframe. This computer is smaller than the supercomputer, but it has a huge storage capacity. This computer is generally used for the business purpose, so it is used in business or in government sector. Mini computer is smaller than supercomputer and mainframe computer. As we can see, it looks like a refrigerator. This computer generally used in client-server architecture, so it is used in universities, polytechnics, companies, and etc. Then last category, which is based on small category. So we have one computer in this category, which is known as microcomputer. This is the smallest type of the computer. This computer is also known as personal computer, as an individual person can operate this computer personally. So this way we can see this, it is a personal computer. Again, microcomputer has some categories that we will see. So first, which computer comes under microcomputer, which is known as desktop computer. Desktop microcomputers are generally cheaper than laptops or notebooks. These computers are reliable and easy to repair. For example, if any component or part of this computer is failed, we can replace that part very easily at lower rates. The next computer, that is a workstation. Workstation, again, it is a special kind of a desktop computer. It is similar to desktop, but this workstation desktop computer has some advanced or special capabilities compared to normal desktop computer. Like it has additional random access memory, it has drives and drives capacity. So this workstation computer generally used in client server architecture. Then laptop. Laptop is smaller in size, it is lightweighted, it has similar features like desktop computer, but the thing is, the important feature about this laptop, that we can use this laptop while traveling also. Then notebook. This computer looks like notebook, that's why it is known as notebook computer. Again, it is smaller and lightweighted than laptop computer. Last category, handheld computers. Handheld computers means those computers which we can handle in our hand. So we have three computers in this category, that is tablet PC, PDA and smartphone. Now one by one we will see the features of this computer. First, tablet PC. It is lightweighted computer. It has flip screen feature. It comes with handwriting recognition. That means it comes with electronic pen, so we can write on its screen also. It also comes with voice recognition feature. Second, that is PDA. PDA, that is personal digital assistant. It is also known as pocket PC. So it looks like a cellular phone. So we can carry this computer in our pocket also. So it functions like cellular phone. So we can make calls using this PC. It comes with touchscreen. It has USB extension port and it also has internet and networking feature. Now last, that is smartphone. Smartphone, basically it is a phone, but some smartphones are available in the market which has computer features. So on the basis of that point, we are including smartphone in the classification of computer. Thank you.